when minus 1 volt, 7 mega ohms, and now OL, open circuit. It is now in cutoff state. When we are increasing gate voltage, the resistance is increasing.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel.
In this session, we are testing this K301 N-channel JFET, Junction Field Effect Transistor. Complete part number is 2SK301, Field Effect Transistor. To test it, set multimeter to resistance or diode. Identify its pinout. For that purpose, we need data sheet. 2SK301 silicon junction field effect transistor, small signal, low frequency amplification for switching. It is high gate drain voltage, 55 volt. Gate to drain, gate to source, 55 volt. And drain current 30 milliampere plus minus. We can operate in any direction, drain to source or source to drain. Then gate current 10 milliampere, gate to source cutoff voltage minus 5 volt maximum. Pin number 1 drain, pin 2 gate, pin 3 source. Set multimeter to resistance. We can also use diode function. Pin 1 drain, center gate, right source, gate to source 2.8 mega ohms, high resistance. Reverse the leads, open. Set to diode, open, swap the leads. It is N-channel JFET. Now it is forward bias because N-channel, drain to source N-channel, gate is P. So it will give indication here with drain and source. This is drain, black lead at source, red lead at gate, one diode in both directions. When testing in reverse direction, it will give open circuit with both leads. Yes, open. Black lead at source, red lead at drain, 0.35 volt. This time the channel is on because the gate is floating. Gate to drain. We need negative voltage to bring it in cutoff state. This time 0.264. This 2SK301, it is used in power supplies for regulation purpose. Set multimeter to resistance. 200 ohms, 225 ohms. Now we need to test its gate cutoff voltage. Common with the common of the multimeter. Stimuli common lead, multimeter common lead, multimeter red lead, and this is stimuli signal to the gate. Now we will monitor gate voltage. DC voltage, now test signal at gate. I applied 0.7 volt, the resistance is 507 ohm, the channel resistance. We will increase the voltage when we are increasing gate voltage, the resistance is increasing. When P-channel gate is increasing, the resistance increasing. Now we will decrease the gate biasing. At around 0 volt, the normal resistance 200 ohms. Now we will decrease the signal in negative side. When minus 1 volt, 7 mega ohms. And now OL, open circuit. It is now in cutoff state. Maximum 5 volt are mentioned in the data sheet, but at minus 1.2 volt, the FET is now in cutoff state. At minus 3.7 volt, it is open circuit. Now we are increasing gate to source voltage. At around minus 0.84 volt in minus 19k resistance. Gate to source voltage below 0 or above 0 will cause to change the channel resistance. We can see when gate voltage are increasing or decreasing, the channel is opening or closing. At 0.69 volt, 486 ohms resistance. We connected multimeter here in ohm mod, and we connected test signal between these two points. This test signal minus 3.7 to 3.7 volt positive variable signal, this one. Between gate to source, when we have 0.97 volt, I applied basically 3.7 volt positive. This time we have 3.7 volt positive, but the junction is dropping 0.965 volt. It is in full conduction mode. Its resistance is 1.4k. When the voltage are decreasing, the resistance is decreasing. When gate to source voltage are 0 volt, the channel resistance is 200 ohms. If the voltage will increase, the resistance will increase. In cutoff state, when in negative side, its resistance will increase. In negative side, when voltage are in minus, it will go in cutoff state as an open circuit. If this video is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.